Hey everyone, this is Doug Jankowski with the Grizzled Geek, coming to you once again with another Heroic Missions walkthrough. On this one, we're going to do Empire side this time. We're going to do Dromund Kaas, and we're going to do it comparing it to Coruscant for the Republic, since they're both the home planets here. First thing you're going to notice right off the bat is you need to do 5 missions on Dromund Kaas instead of the 4 that you have to do on Coruscant. The other thing you'll quickly notice is that not a single one of these is in its own instance. They're all in open areas, which are going to make them considerably tougher. Alright, we'll head out to the first one. I'm not going to do these in any particular order because they all pose their own challenges. Since they are in open areas, it takes you have to work to find...
Shall we?
Find the targets that you're going to need. Luckily, it doesn't look like we've got much competition going on here, so hopefully we can do this relatively quickly.
We will make them fall.
Unless it presents itself during the course of this, I'm not going to do the bonuses probably on any of these because they are so... I don't want to say they're tough, they're not really hard, they're just so long. First thing you gotta do is you gotta get through three of the demolition guys, so you gotta look for those. When there's a lot of people, those can be relatively tough to find because so many people are trying to find them and they are limited targets. There we got them. Okay, so we're gonna go and start detonating our shuttles. We actually are gonna have to backtrack for one, which is unfortunate. So we've got 3 sets of explosives. We're gonna have to detonate 3 different shuttles marked on here, so we gotta go back for this one and then forward to that one, and then there's another stage beyond that where we have to fight basically the commander of that force, so that'll take a little while. So you can already see this is way more complicated than any single one on Coruscant. The closest kill comes the Face Merchants, which is multi-staged, but not that multi-stage. I mean, it's 2 stages. This is 2 stages. This is actually more like 3 stages. You know, collect up the explosives, then blow up the shuttles, then take out the commander. So, yeah, kind of a pain. Try and avoid most fights here to speed things along, but if things get in our way, we may go ahead. We may end up getting 20 kills just incidentally. way, it may be worth actually just grabbing the last few. Excellent, and the last two will be the ones guarding the shuttle, so we're actually going to get the bonus experience here, or bonus CXP, so that's nice. Alright. There we go, now we head to find the commander of the invasion force. And defeat her and her apprentices.
Gratham was behind the transmissions that allowed her invasion.
All right, so there's the first one. As you can see, that's quite a bit longer. I mean, that in and of itself took about half as long as just to running the Coruscant missions does. So in this case, and in almost all others, the Empire actually has a distinct disadvantage on the heroics. Theirs are considerably more difficult, harder to get done because of the fact that they're in open areas like this. You can see here, this area has been almost entirely depopulated. To wait for people to respawn here.
Make them fall.
Bad, since most everything was respawning as we got here. That's cool. So we'll be able to finish this one relatively quickly. Probably only about 2 minutes. Which is about on par. That's about what we should see for these beginner planets. The time for completing.
So much galaxy yet to explore and heal.
Right, so let's go ahead and head on to this one. Is another one that's not a difficult fight. It just takes a while to get to, as it's in the temple here. And often there's a lot of. It's one guy. He takes 5 minutes to respawn, and there's often competition to get him. What you can really hope for is that you find cool people while you're there who are willing to team up so that you all get the credit for it. But we'll see here. Oh, somebody has been here recently. Let's see if this guy will join the group. There you go. Oh, more coming. Okay. So we've got a nice little group here, so hopefully we'll be okay for getting this guy when he respawns. Alright, there we go. He spawned, finally. We were able to take him out. And I'm going to go ahead and move on to saving face. Thank the group. And, now, this is probably the easiest of the flashpoints on Dromund Kaas. These are roughly equivalent to maybe the enemies of the Republic. In the Jedi Temple in ease. So just run over here, grab the explosives. Sometimes there's guys there defending it, sometimes they haven't respawned yet. Go activate the drill, fight three sets of ads, they'll come in here. All right, and last one, the shadow shadow spawn. This also is a multi-tier, rather long one, at least distance-wise. Sometimes it's not that bad. It looks like somebody's gone before. for us and cleared the way, and the bodies usually respawn to get the runes off of them quicker than the adds around the area will respawn. So that'll make that a little bit easier. Steal that from us. I'll go get this one down here first. So the adds are pretty easy, and it's not, you know, gathering the runes is not that tough. They're just a decent amount of area to cover, especially for a starting world. And if you're following behind somebody, you're going to have to wait for things to respawn. But by and large, it's not difficult, it's just time consuming. Okay, respawned already. These luckily have a pretty quick respawn timer. So it's not that bad. Go. That's the most efficient route to grab all of the runes, and then once you've got them all, you're gonna head over this way to this cave back here. If you grab any adds, just keep going. They'll drop off by the time you get to the cave, usually. And then just head on in. For this, you're gonna have to know your Sith code, and know which runes to click on. Areas where you actually have to open up your mission tab. So let's go ahead and this running into an error here. Okay, so we go over here, we've got our Rune of Passion, got our Rune of Victory, got our Rune of Power, Rune of Freedom, and Rune of Strength. So, I think that's the right order. Let's see if I remember my Sith code. Oh, it actually gives you clues down below. For some reason that one didn't take. And finally, come on. And then you'll have to fight the creature that comes out now that you've... I already did. Let's go. Alright, so then, just a quick battle against this champion level rope. cat here in spawn. Guess he's my dad. He's actually a champion, so. Alright, there we go. So that's the. The planetary missions for Dromund Kaas. It did take us almost right around 20 minutes to complete, so nearly twice as long as the Coruscant Heroics takes. Definitely the Empire has the downside on this. You know, it has a much tougher Heroics to deal with. And as we go through the other planetary missions, you're going to see that that's a pretty much constant refrain. Some are relatively close in difficulty levels. Some are insanely far apart, especially when we get to Alderaan. We'll see how much more difficult the Empire has it there. But anyways, I'd like to hear your comments below about what you think about the Dromund Kaas Heroics, the planetary mission, any planets you can think of where the Empire might actually have the advantage, that theirs are a little easier to get through. I'm not aware of any, but that's, you know, I'm not, definitely not the end-all be-all of that. And any tips or tricks you have for getting through the Heroics faster, I'd love to hear them. Anyways, if you would, please hit that like button, subscribe for notifications on more videos as I put them out. And you all enjoy playing Star Wars The Old Republic. May the Force be with you, and I'll see you next week. Thank you for joining me for another Star Wars The Old Republic video. We here at The Grizzled Geek are working tirelessly to provide you with more content and upgrading our equipment for greater production values. But we need your help. We've set up a Patreon page where you can become a Patreon at varying levels of support with a variety of rewards at each level. If you would prefer a one-time gift of support, visit us at our GoFundMe page. Links for both are down below. Either way, we appreciate you being here, checking out our videos, and I'd encourage you to check out what else the channel has to offer. We look forward to seeing you in the weeks, months, and years to come and interacting with you as a community. Thank you very much for your support.